Hi, my name is Adi Abed. I'm the Switchgear product line manager at Southwest Electric Company. Another common question that we get is the difference between metal-clad switchgear and metal-enclosed switchgear. We can start with a simple statement, which is every metal-clad switchgear is metal-enclosed, but not every metal-enclosed switchgear is metal-clad. The major and main difference is the separation of the bus compartment from the cable compartment, because each of these types of equipment basically could have a draw-out circuit breaker, could have a separated low-voltage compartment. However, you need to barrier the main bus. In this example, this is like unfinished equipment. It's still being built. We can see the bushings for the cradles of the circuit breaker inside. This is the location for where the bus is going to pass, and this is going to be the main bus. Lower bushings from the upper breaker, top bushings from the lower breaker. It's going to tap into the main bus, and it's going to be covered with a steel sheet of metal. The rear part of this compartment is going to be basically the cable compartment, where for the lower cradle is going to connect to the bottom bushings, and for the upper cradle is going to connect to the top bushings. In any piece of equipment, if you open, let's say, the front doors and you've seen bus, or you've seen copper, or you've seen cables, this means that that equipment is metal enclosed. If you open the front door and you've seen probably a circuit breaker, and you haven't seen any cables, you haven't seen any bus, then it's possible it's metal clad, or it could be still metal enclosed. And to know for sure, you need to come to the rear of that equipment and look on the cable compartment and the main bus if they're separated or not. At Southwest Electric, we can design your equipment tailored to your needs.